I'm rolling. Check, check, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, for recording purposes. If I get your name, please.
Kristen Carter.
And the name of your new single is?
Karma.
Let's do this. Coming down in 3, 2, and 1. And thank you so much for making time for me. You've had a busy schedule today, and I want people to know who are listening, watching this whole interview on Rudy Blair Entertainment Media, the fact that I saw you this morning on CP24, and I was like, oh, I was hoping I was going to get that interview, but, you know, busy schedule. And then somehow the folks here at the CCMAs, where we are right now, they provided a space. And you're here, and we get to talk. So thank you so much.
Thank you for having me. I'm glad it worked out. You know, we made it happen.
How has your visit here in Toronto been?
Oh, it's been so awesome. Yeah, this is my first time really spending some time in Toronto. Mm-hmm. I've been here once or twice on plane layovers and once to visit a friend at university really quickly. But this is my first time diving into the city, going around all the different areas, and it's been so great. Toronto has a great vibe, I gotta say.
Well, you know why? It's because it's a little bit warmer than it was like last week. Last week, I don't know. Well, no, then again, we kind of started the Christmas season last week, so either way, we're just happy that you're here anyways. So, and congratulations on Karma. How does it feel about having a single out now?
Oh, it's so great. You know, when you're working on a song for so long and you keep it to yourself, you just want more than anything to show it to everybody. So it's really nice to finally be able to put that out there and see the reaction from people and hear what people think of the song and, you know, what they take away from it. And I just, yeah, it's an incredible experience. My first time doing it, so all of it's been new and very, very exciting.
Fantastic. Well, look, I want to get into that. I want to get into Dallas Smith. I want to get into a lot of different things, but I want to get into the love of music because from, I understand from Yay High, you've been singing in choirs everywhere.
Yeah, so that's where music really started for me, and my love of music grew was in choir. I was in choir since I was about 5, all the way up through university, and that's really where I think I can credit my learning how to sing. I had amazing conductors growing up that would kind of push me forward and do some, you know, go do the solo, that kind of thing. So I think there was some foreshadowing to doing the solo singing. But yeah, it's a really fun community, and I loved choir so, so much.
Oh my God, it reminds me of, what was the scene again, where in the Whoopi Goldberg movie, where she is a nun, and when Sister Act, when she was younger, she was out singing everybody, and they had to, that kind of reminds me, was it something like that?
Kind of, yeah, I think they're just being really young, and they're just like, hey, do you remember that part? Do you want to stand in front of this, like, little metal stick and do it in front of everybody, right? So.
But somewhere country music came into this. What about, what is it about the love of country music for you?
Country has always been in my life. Mm-hmm. So it's the music I listened to growing up, Faith Hill, Shania Twain, the Dixie Chicks. That was the era for me that I loved the most and what I grew up listening to. So when I did start writing music eventually and starting to do a solo thing and stepping out on my own, it just came out country because that's what I had known. And yeah, I don't know if I ever had a definitive moment of I'm doing country music. I think it was just in me the whole time.
Okay, but do you remember the first time seeing any one of your idols? I'm assuming you have growing up. Who was it and what was that experience like?
The first time I saw Shania, she was the first one I've seen. I saw the Dixie Chicks after her. Love mm-hmm. them both. But it wasn't even that long ago. It was maybe 3 years ago, four wow. years ago. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and it was just so incredible to see all of that come together and all of that happen. And really still knowing all of the words, I was really surprised. Mm-hmm. I don't know if I could write a test right now and get 100, but, you know, it's like I can try my best because the Come On Over album was such a huge album for me growing up. And we would just stick it in the car and we didn't have a CD changer. It was just the one CD. So it would get you from A to B and you'd go through and learn all the words, right? So yeah, it's just, there's nothing like seeing people that you look up to so much right in front of you and doing what they love and doing such a good job of it. It's really inspiring.
What's inspiring too, Dallas Smith, Steelhead.
Yes.
Steelhead music, he has really become somebody who is a champion of Canadian country music. How did you two get involved? Like, how did you guys meet and how do you think he's inspired you to be the artist that you are today.
Yeah, crazy, right? I still can't even believe it came together. But I'd been friends with Sean Austin for a few years.
Oh, love Sean.
Yeah, he's great, right? Just performing around Vancouver in the bars and stuff, that kind of scene. And one day we just decided to put out an Instagram duet together, a Lady A song that we did, just for fun. Mm. And it caught Dallas's attention. And so he sent me a message to my Instagram. And after I got over the fact and like told everyone I knew that Dallas Smith sent me a message on Instagram saying he liked my voice, we just started talking from there, and I'd put out some more stuff, and he would send me another message, just kind of asking, you know, what are you up to? What are you doing? I really like your voice. Maybe we should talk, that kind of stuff. And yeah, it snowballed, and here we are. So pretty crazy.
What is it like to work with him in the studio? I know Sean told me that, you know, it would be like he'd sing something, and Dallas would come and go, no, try it this way. And like, he's very, very hands-on. Was he like that with you?
Yeah, so we've only been in the studio together actually once. Mm-hmm. And yeah, he is very much that way. Like, he'll run in from the control room and come in and be like, no, this, like, and I'm just like, oh my God, he's so good. But yeah, no, and I appreciate that so much because, you know, he just wants it to be really good, and he's really involved with the whole process, which is incredible because he's someone who I've looked up to for years, and to have somebody who you idolize so much championing you and investing in you is a really indescribable feeling. So I'm really lucky.
And we have to give a congratulations because he's got that new clothing line. So big congratulations on that too. Are you going to be wearing any of these when you're performing? Just curious.
I hope so. I mean, I'm big into outfits, mm-hmm. if you can tell. And so I'm happy to try any and all fashion and outfits for sure.
Okay. What's fashionable right now is the new single Karma. Now that word karma is a big word, so it could mean a lot of different things. For this single, for your song, what does it mean? What is karma about?
So, as you said, I think karma can mean a lot of different things to a lot of people. But for me, I just kind of got these visuals of, you know, justice and how, you know, what goes around comes around, those kind of vibes. And that's what really struck me most about the song right away. It wasn't a song that I wrote myself. It was a pitch that came to me. And it was actually co-written by Maren Morris, which is pretty crazy that even fell into my lap. But it did, and here we are somehow. And yeah, I just think like that is what struck me about it. It was so unapologetic, so brave, and so strong in the writing and the melody. And I think that kind of resonates with what Karma is about in general. So I thought the song kind of fit with the vibe, and it was in tune with a lot of things that I wanted to come out with as an artist and how I wanted to showcase myself. So felt like a good fit right from the beginning.
What's the fan reaction been like for you?
Pardon me, sorry.
Fan reaction, what's it been like?
Yeah, I think it's been really fun because some parts of the song, the way I interpret it, mm-hmm. People have a completely different interpretation of it, right? So that's been really fun to listen to it and see how people pick up all these different little things, or how everyone's has a different favorite part of the song or little moment. Like for me, I love the little things that Scott and I kind of hide in the back, like the little like call and response things mm-hmm. that are behind the melody. So I love listening for that. But some people will be like, oh, I love this sound on it, or I really like this word, or yeah, this fires me up because I just broke up with my boyfriend and karma, you know, right? So that's really cool, and it's neat to speak to people in that way, because I think music is just such a fabulous way to emote and to evoke feelings in people, and you know, I think that's sometimes it's hard on a day-to-day to really be vulnerable and live those things out. So I think music allows people to be able to do that, and I'm seeing a little bit of that with some of the comments we're getting. So
very true. With a great single, will there be more singles? Will there be an EP? Will there be an album for 2020? What are we looking at?
No definitive plans for an EP quite yet, mm-hmm. but definitely have a lot more music that I'm really excited to show everyone and that we're working on. So definitely, you know, stay tuned because I've got some really cool stuff coming I'm excited to share.
What about performances in 2020? And any chance, even though we were talking earlier, we are at the CCMA offices, any chance that you might be there too in 2020?
I hope so. I'm definitely going to be there in 2020 in Hamilton. Really excited about that. Mm-hmm. And I was lucky enough to get an opening spot on Tay Bay's tour in BC. So,
fantastic.
Yeah, thanks.
Oh my goodness. See, another mentor, another guy who is just about, you know, celebrating not just Canadian country music, but music in general, period.
Oh, yeah.
Sounds fantastic. Look, before we get out of here, because of when we're doing this interview, mm-hmm. Holiday season, Christmas season is coming up. Mm-hmm. What was your favorite Christmas or holiday moment, whether it had been a toy you got as a kid or a moment that happened? What was your favorite?
So one of my favorite Christmas moments or holiday moments is My mom is like the Martha Stewart of White Rock, so she just goes for it, right? The whole house transforms. It's pretty awesome. And every year she does this big day with all my friends that we call Gingerbread Day, and she just makes all these beautiful little cutouts of the houses, and we all make them together. And like, keep in mind, me and my friends are in our mid to late 20s, so like, you know, to have my mom do all of this for us is so nice. But yeah, every year it happens, and we all get together, and I think sometimes it's easy to let traditions kind of pass by because we're busy. You know, as you get older, it's not maybe not as magical because you're not as young, but I think that, you know, it really, it does have that magic still when you make it happen, and when you spend the time and, you know, spend time with people who you're close to and make those things happen and make moments for it. So my mom's really good at that.
Are you kidding? Let me see. I'm smelling gingerbread right now. Okay, yeah, I hear exactly what you're saying. Look, in case hopefully you'll take pictures and put it on Instagram of this stuff. Social media is the place to go. Where do we go to follow you?
Yes, so my Instagram is at Kristen Carter Music, and I have a website as well, KristenCarterMusic.com, with links to all my other socials.
Fantastic. Congratulations on a new single, Karma. Looking forward to everything that's happened to you in 2020. And cross fingers, yeah, we will be seeing you at the CCMAs in 2020. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for having me.